Hey everyone, it's Jen, and today I'm going to do a bit of a different video for you. I've wanted to do one of these for a long time, but I had my coloring card actually stashed behind a bunch of stuff, so I wasn't able to access it. And then when quarantine happened, I actually took the entire card out of where I had it in the back of my couch, and I said to Frank that I'm going to be coloring a lot, so I kind of want to have my things near me. And so we took it out from there, and then we rearranged that entire area. We took the table out and all that kind of stuff. So now I'm able to get to it easier, which is nice because I have pretty much my most used coloring things on it. And I had seen Sammy do a video like this a long, long time ago, maybe 2 years ago, at least a year ago. And I always wanted to do one, but since I couldn't access my stuff, I couldn't do it. But now I figured little man is having a nap, and since I can't access it, I'm going to show you what's on my coloring card, and I'm going to show you my most used coloring things. Some of the things that I use are not on the cart, but I use all the time. So what I do is, for those of you that don't know, I actually color primarily on my couch, and because of that, I don't have like a designated craft room, so I keep a bag with me at all times. I can actually show it to you. It's a Vera Bradley Disney bag that my mother bought for me last year for my birthday. So I keep my coloring books that I'd like to color in with me, because I have a closet full of coloring books, so I pick out some ones that I think I want to color in, and then keep them, sorry, this bag is gigantic. I keep them in this bag. And I also keep my pencils that I'm currently using, and like my pencil case and things like that. So I don't actually like have a place where I can go and sit and just use my cart. I kind of keep the cart next to me on the couch. And I've always done that. So I'm going to start at the bottom, and I know you can kind of see me a little bit. I'm trying to stay out of it. And if you're wondering why I have a sweatshirt on in like 95 degree heat, it's because I love the cold weather and I keep the house very cold. I keep it at like 66, 67 so that I can be cozy all the time. Also, like I said, little man's having a nap right now, so it's nice and cool for him. I don't know if he's going to wake up during this, but we're going to try to do this before he gets up. So I'm going to try to pan you down as much as I can, and I'm going to pull the things off the cart so you can see what I have. So I just showed this in a haul. This is my Toy Story pencil case that I got from the Amazon UK. It has in it all of my glittery things and my Posca pens. I don't know if you can really see it. And it has like gel pens, white gel pens, Wink of Stella, Spectrum Noir, those kinds of things. So I use that pretty often, but since it's so chunky monkey, I mean, it is, it's pretty much to the max capacity. I do keep it on the shelf just so that I can access it easy and it's not blocking up my bag. In here, this is a Barnes & Noble pencil case, and in here I have just the, what are these called things? The Copic At You Speaker pens. I don't know if that's what you really call them, but that's what I have in there. That's all that I keep in there. I don't use those too much anymore. I used to use them a lot, but I just don't use them that much anymore. I have this Star Wars pencil case that Pink Eyed Pro sent me a long time ago, Sherry, and I've always used it ever since she sent it to me back when I first started making coloring videos. I've always used it. So in here I just have, well actually I have a Spectrum Noir glitter pen, and then I have all of the Sakura jelly roll pens in here. So that's just basically what I keep in there, and I do use those kind of regularly. I used to use them a whole lot more. This is my original, I got this for free from the Blick store, and this is my original swatch book. So I've moved into a new swatch book now, but I do have some of my old ones in here that I have not replaced into the new swatch book, so I just keep that there. I have this little Mickey Mouse pencil case, which I love so much. And in here I just have some erasers and sharpener thingy-majiggies and like replacement blades from the sharpener, the M&R sharpener. I have an extra M&R sharpener. I have some clips, just basically sharpeners and a little bit of erasers that I keep in there. And then this cute little, it's like a little metal tin. I found out about this from Sammy, and I keep all of my eraser things in here. So I have like long erasers, I have these cute little candy corn erasers, some refills for the electric eraser, which I don't even have anymore, so I don't know why I keep those. I have the Faber-Castell erasers in there. Okay, the next thing I have is one of these plastic, I forget what they call them, Japanese writing tablets, is that what they're called, writing pads or whatever, that I put in the back of my pages so that if I'm doing watercolors or markers or whatever, it won't go through. So I have that. Usually I keep that in my bag because I use that pretty much every day. These are the Kaiser Craft gel pens that I showed you guys in a haul recently. This is the 24 set. Love these. Absolutely beautiful gel pens. Really pretty colors on those. I use those most right now because, you know, we fall in and out of love with things. And there's always new things coming out, so we try new things. I cannot get this closed, so I'll have to do it later. I also have my Arteza Inconic 120 fine liners. So I just showed those also in a haul. So I have those. I have my 84 Neo colors, which I love. I don't use them enough, but now that I have like reorganized how I keep my stuff, I've been using them more because I'm able to get to them easier. Before, I used to have to like lean over the couch, and these were always on the bottom, and it was just like a pain, so I just never reached for them. But now I can. Here I have my Faber-Castell pastel pencils. I've like hardly ever used these. I've hardly ever used them. They are lovely. I just don't use them enough, but they are really, really beautiful pencils. They're only set of pastel pencils that I have. Here I have my Kohinoor Magical pencils. So I'm sure you haven't seen these in quite a while, but these are those really big, thick pencils that are like rainbow colored. I totally even forgot I had these, so I need to start using those again, find something to use them on, maybe even my color by numbers. We'll see if I can work those in. And then what I need to get these out of here actually. This is my 80 set of the Caran d'Ache Super Colors. I have the full set of Super Colors in one of the pencil cases up here, so I don't know why I keep this on here. It's just always been here, so that's why it's there. But you know what? I think I'm actually going to move this to where I store my extras. Let's say hi. Hi. Hi, Snowy. Snowy's filming. Snowy's making videos. Little Snowy. Just a little Snowy. Hi, Snowy. Look at her. Oh my God, what a ham. Okay, she's probably gonna sit on my lap for the rest of this. Okay, so now we're gonna go on to shelf two. So on shelf two, I have my absolutely most used pencil case, which I'm very sad about because I see it's got like a hole in it, but I could always buy another one. But this is my Mickey pencil case, which I show pretty much it's in all my videos. This has my most used pencils, my erasers, my skin tones for Prismacolors. It's got a little card in it that Color and Chat with Sammy sent me for Christmas, and I just keep in there because I love it. And I have this, what do you call this thing? I don't know. Eraser. It's one of those electric erasers. It's nice. I like this one better than the Derwent. And then in here I just have some paintbrushes, blenders, obviously my coloring assistant is up so I apologize. I have some, what are these things called, Sharpie pens, blenders, erasers, an extra sharpener, and just some little like clippy things, so I have all those in there. In my Minnie Mouse case, I currently have water things. So I have all my water brushes in there. There's also a pencil in there that doesn't belong in there, so let me move that. And my little paintbrushes and a water brush that I got, I think, from the Blick store. And then like a rag. This is from the Pablo set that I just keep in there for if I need something quick to wipe off one of my brushes. So that's what's in there. Okay, a lot of the things on this shelf are like watercolor things, and then I have a few pencil sets. So random things that I have is like a top that I would use for my like acrylic paints if I needed it. I also have these little, they're little like plastic containers that we got, I want to say from like Friday is when we ordered out one day, and I ended up cleaning them and saved them. They had like ketchup or something in them, and I saved them because I thought they would be good for when Emilio and I do painting, and we actually did. We put some acrylic paints in there and we used them for that, so that was fun. I also can use that for water, and they have little tops on them, so if I wanted to put like my sharpener in that and take it someplace and it's small, I could. I also, I don't know if you have this yogurt by you, but this is the Wii yogurt, and it comes in a really nice glass jar, so I really wanted to use this for water when I'm doing like painting or something like that, so when I finished the yogurt, I just saved it, and Frank put it in the dishwasher for me. Okay, I got this from, I don't know, some store. It wasn't like a dollar, it was just like a beauty supply store for my watercolors. It's like a little spray bottle. And then I found this on scrapbook.com. This is Distress Sprayer Vaporisator. I don't know, that's what it says on there, but it's for the distressed inks, I guess. But it's a really nice spray bottle, and it's kind of small. I just really like it, and I like the way it sprays. So I have that one too for watercolors and things. I have a few of the Colero, I don't know, metallic paints. I love these things. They are so pretty and they just come out so beautiful. So I have the Earth set, I have the Rainbow set, and then I have this Ganzai Tambi Starry Colors Kuretake like gold set. Beautiful. I have a new black acrylic paint. This is Apple Barrel. I think I bought these like years and years ago when I was doing a lot of acrylic paint. Well, not acrylic painting, but I was using the paints to do like ceramics and stuff like that. So I have like a whole stash of these. I have a CraftSmart black one. I have CraftSmart white and Americana white. And then I have these little erasers that go with the Tihu electric eraser. It came with it. It's like 100 erasers or something like that in there. And they come in this like really nice little plastic box. So I do appreciate that. And this is one of my favorite watercolor sets. This is a Jane Davenport Brights. Of all of her sets, this one's definitely my favorite and the one that I use the most. So I'm sure you've seen Dee Dee use these. I got the inspiration to do the card like this from her, and I love this set. I use it a lot, especially in my summer pictures. This is a small travel watercolor set that Arteza sent me, and I really do like their watercolors. I don't use this one too much. I use the bigger one because obviously I like the more selection of colors, but for a little travel set, this is really nice. This is another one of the Jane Davenport sets. I don't remember what this one's called. Let's look at the, this is the natural, is it the natural or neutral? Neutral palette. So here's what the little thing looks like. And the only thing I don't like about these Jane Davenports is they come out really easy. So if this thing ever falls off my cart, they're all over the place and then I have to figure out which goes where. But even though I still really like her watercolor things. And actually, that was sent to me for my birthday from Lisa. And then I have the C, is it, what is this one called? This is the Jane Davenport Glitzy Palette. This is my probably least used one. It's okay. You know, it doesn't really like get me going or anything. It's just okay. But I'm a completist and I like to have everything as long as it's something that I like. So, you know, I do use them here and there, but they're just not my most used colors. Here I have, I don't even know what you call this. It's, I know the Pan Pastels, obviously, but we got them at the Blick store. They were having a clearance, like a manager's clearance. And at that time, everything was on sale for $2, and even the manager's clearance stuff. And they gave this, because we're friends with them in there, we go in there a lot, and they gave this whole thing to me for like $2. Which has a lot of different colors in it, like just the basic colors and whatnot. I've hardly used them. But it also comes with a few little tools on the bottom, so that's nice, and it's very easily stored because of the little packaging that it comes in. All right, so here I have my Arteza watercolor set. They sent this to me, and I love this set. The colors are beautiful. You can see, if you want to see a video on them, you can see I use these a lot. because there are just such beautiful colors in this. Everything basically that you would need, you have here in this set. And you have really like the beautiful tins to use if you want to mix them. You have like a really large palette here. Really nice. I really like these. I mean, you can see this thing is banged up because I use it a lot. All right, this is something new that I just got. This is the Faber-Castell watercolors. So this is probably my new favorite watercolor set. I just got these last week. I think I got them on Friday of last week, and they are so beautiful. I love these. This is a 48 set, so this has a few more colors than the Arteza's, and it has the neons, and it has a few metallics in it. I don't like the water brush, but everything else, amazing. I started using the watercolors to put them on a summer nights picture, and they blend, and they're so, oh my gosh, love these. This is Karen, KJ Designs by Karen. She makes her own watercolors, and she sent me a set of these for review. So they're all a little like mixed up, but you can see a video of them on my channel, and these are beautiful colors. They just come out so lovely. I found the best way to use these metallics is to put color down first and then put the metallic color over it. You can also color over the metallics and it still will shine through. So they're very beautiful, and you can find these if you're interested on her Etsy shop, and that is her Etsy shop, KJ Designs by Karen. This is another one by Karen. She sent this to me as a gift, which was so nice. These are all of her blue colors. Well, not all of her blue colors, but a large selection of her blue and like tealish colors. I love them. I've used them in a, you can see I've used them many times in my different projects that I work on for coloring, and they're just beautiful. What can I say other than they're just beautiful? And like I said, you can find all of her colors on her Etsy store. And this is one more, KJ Designs by Karen. This is her, I bought this set. This was her glitter set, I want to say. I don't remember exactly what she called it, but look at these babies. The camera can't even like focus on it because it's just so, so glittery. But they are really beautiful. I like working with them, especially like the dark one. It just comes out so fantastic. Okay, the next set of watercolors I have, I got these a long, long time ago. These are the Kowei watercolors. Kauai, I don't know what you call them. But they don't look like much here, but they are really, really pretty. Let me show you. I have them in this, I think I have them in this swatch book right here. They're not like terribly expensive, and they're really pretty. Okay, so here is what they look like. Obviously, they look completely different in the swatches than they do in the container, but really pretty colors, and I've definitely used these colors. I've used this palette. You can see it's been used many times, so I recommend that as well. And then I have my glitter palettes. This is my Pablo Metallics, which you can see I've used. I'm glad that you can see that I actually use these things, because people might think I just like collect stuff and never use them, but I do definitely use them. And then these are the ones that Arteza recently sent me, and I think I actually like these better than the Pablos, to be honest with you. I think they're a little bit more pigmented than the Pablos. I've shown these also on my channel if you want to see, but there's a swatch on the black paper and a swatch on the light paper, and they're just really beautiful colors. I really recommend them if you're like me and you like metallic glittery things. Okay, this is a Colorit case. I do believe I had the Colorit pencils at one time, but I didn't buy them for that. I bought them for the case because I really wanted this case, and I put my Derwent ink tents in them, which I don't use my ink tents enough, but they are all in here safe and sound, and whenever I get the feeling or the urge to use them, I have them right here, and I love them. They're beautiful, beautiful colors, fun to work with. I just need to work with them more to learn how to do more with them. In here, I don't even know what I have. Let's see. I have some pencils in here. Oh, so these are the Erogetins. I don't have all of the Erogetins in here. I just put my most used ones in here because I wanted to move them from the case that they were in, and they didn't all fit in here. So I just put the ones in here that were my most used. So It's typically the pastels and the neons. And then the last thing on this shelf is another pencil set. I think these are the Blicks. Yeah, so these are the Blick pencils that I have in here. These are really nice pencils. I've used these, not as much as my other pencils, obviously, but I have used them, and I do like them a lot. You probably really couldn't even see that. Sorry. It's hard filming like this. So I'm going to put all these things back, and then we'll do the last shelf. Okay, so I'm going to show you the last shelf here. This is the top shelf. This is where I have all my colored pencils. Now, they're not all my colored pencils. Obviously, I have some in that shelf. I have some here, and I have some that don't even fit, but I do keep them in my bag, so it kind of works out as I switch them out. So I'll just show you the ones that I keep in my bag that I'm working with right now are my Prismacolors. This is the Thornton's art supply company with this case. I love this case. I have this for both my Prismas and my Holbeins. I found out about this from the Colorful Book Nester. I think that's the name of her channel. Typically, I don't zipper it, but you can, and it keeps the pencils really nice and safe in there. And these are my two favorite cases that I have, aside from the unicorn one, which I talked about the other day because I'm five. And I love them, so I'm just trying to zipper this. So, yeah, it's really nice. It holds them in nice. This is one of my favorites. It used to always be covered in pug hair, but not anymore since my pugs are gone. And then I have my Polychromos in this. This is probably one of those BTKSY ones or whatever they call them. I chose the green because the box for the Polychromos is green, so that's why I got this. This was before they had all the little fancy like doodad ones now that they have, but those are the ones that I'm working with right now, so those are in my bag. Also in my bag, or what I keep with me, are the Parcou markers. So Parcou sent me these for a review, which I did put up a video, and you know what? I fell in love with these markers. They are my most used marker by far. I've used them on any project, or I shouldn't say same project, but any picture that I've colored lately that has markers on it are the Parcou markers. It comes with the little swatching chart, which I did, and you can just see how pretty these colors are. And when these run out, I will definitely be rebuying these. Like, I didn't buy the first ones, they sent them to me, but I will be buying the second set because I love them. They are so nice. They come in this nice little case that it just won't spill. You could take it with you any room you want, which is, works for me because, like I said, I go from room to room. Love those. All right, these are the 120 set of Arteza's, and this is the Arteza pencil case. They sent all of this to me, which I do have a video up on my channel for this stuff, so you can see the reviews. They also had sent me, I think, the 72 set before they had the 120 set, and I have those put away because I'm just using these right now. So, yeah, really, really love those pencils. Okay, I don't even know what's in some of these. I think these are the Spira Farben pencils in here. Yeah, so these are the Spira Farbens. Really pretty pencils. I just saw they have a new set, like a 96 set out. I don't know if I'm going to go for those. I'm waiting for the new Black Widow ones to come out, but these are really nice, and I love the cute little case that it comes with. I have another case that's like that. It's a little bit different, but this one has the 76 set of the Luminance. So these are my new Luminance pencils that I bought. I had a smaller set. I don't remember how many it was, but I went ahead and got the bigger set when quarantine started, and I love these. So I've just been using the bigger set. I think these are my Pablos, the Caran d'Ache Pablos. Yes, so I bought the silver one because the case said the Pablos come in silver, so I tried to do it that way so I could remember what was in what case. But these, I hardly use my Pablos, to be honest with you. I need to use them more. I kind of get stuck on a set here and there, and that's what I use. But they are beautiful pencils, and what I have used them on, I've enjoyed. In here, I think I have, I want to say Supercolors. So, yeah, that's what's in here, the Caran d'Ache Supercolors. So these are the watercolor, like Caran d'Ache pencils. Love these pencils both wet and dry. I use them more dry than wet, to be honest with you. So I have the full set in there. What is it, the 120 set or something, whatever it is. And then I have the anniversary set in here. I didn't go ahead and mix them in with the other colors. I just wanted to keep the anniversary set separate. So that's why I have them in there like that. I think I have a mixed pencils in here. I have all different things. So I have the Faber-Castell. This is so hard to do. Faber-Castell Gold Fabers here, which I love these pencils. I got these right. I don't know why I remember these things, but I got these right before we went to Disney World 1 year, and it was the year that I got the shingles in Disney World. When we came back, everybody had a family party to go to, and I couldn't go because I had the shingles. And I remember sitting on the couch for hours and coloring with these, and I just had such a good time with them. They are so fun. These are the Derwent drawing pencils, the brownish ones. These are the Graphitints, the Derwents. These are also Graphitint. These are the Kohinoor, like, rainbowish ones, which I said I haven't used them very much, but I need to. But yeah, it's all just a mixed bag in that one of different things. In this little case, I have the Black Widows, all of the sets in here. So I have the skin tones in here. I didn't mix them in with the others. I just kept them separately. And then I did try to organize them, the rest of the Black Widows. I don't know if you could see that when I was showing that, but I tried to organize the rest of them based on the list that Color by Claire created for these. So that's that. And then I have some room in here for when the new set of comes out of the I think it's 24 set that's coming out, the Monarch pencils. So if it's a 24 set, it'll fit in here. If it's a 48 set, not gonna fit in here, but I'm hoping it will, so I have that room in there. This one I just showed in a haul the other day. This is my unicorn case that I just got, and I have in here my 120 set of Crayolas and then the Crayola twistable pencils. Primarily I use these on Color by Numbers and also with my son. So he's 5, so this is perfect for us to use these things together. They're the twistables, and they all fit in here very nicely, nice and snug. And then the last thing that I have is another one of those Thornton Art Supply cases. I got these on Amazon. I don't know if they're still available. They came with pencils, but the pencils were crap, so I threw those out. But anyway, these have my beauties, my Holbeins. I love you guys. I don't use them enough anymore. I need to use them more. But you can see I have used them plenty. There's plenty of short pencils in here. I think Color with Claire said that in the UK they were selling them as singles, so I definitely need to replace a few. I need to find out about how to do that. But yeah, so that is everything on my coloring card, to everything that I use most often, with the exception of probably the thing that I use most often is my big old bag of Stickles. So I don't keep this on my coloring card because it's too big and it's too heavy. I keep this in the cabinet, but here is my Stickles, and these are just my new Stickles, the new ones that I got. I ordered some of them during quarantine. I fell in love with the new colors that they have out, like unicorn and mermaid's tail and all those kind of like summery type colors. So I ordered those, but here is the rest of my Stickles. I've shown this before in videos, but this entire thing is full to the brim of Stickles. I probably have every color they have, and I love my Stickles, and for those of you guys that have watched me for some time, you know I use my Stickles. So that is it. That is everything I have on the cart for you guys. I hope you enjoyed watching this. This was fun to make. I've wanted to do this for a long time, so I feel good about this. So leave me some comments. Let me know if you have any of these things, if you have a coloring cart. If you have any pictures of your coloring cart, some people have been sending me their pictures of their cart, and I would love to see it because I absolutely love to see what other people have. I love watching these videos. So let me know. Leave a comment, and I will see you real soon.